started right here.
Since you came,
hey,
into my life,
I've been all right. This is rock.
I've been all right.
Rock it like this, rock it like this, hey. I've been changed.
I've been changed.
Nothing's the same.
Nothing's the same.
Jesus, you are my life.
You are my life.
If you love Jesus, somebody scream as loud as you can. Welcome to the very first episode of the Tim and Brelyn Show.
Yes! Babe, I am so excited.
Not more excited than me.
No, I'm so excited.
Well,
I got
you look good.
I'm just trying to match your fly, that's all.
Listen, we have so much in store for you for this very first season. We have
amazing.
Some great singers. Some teachers.
Some preachers.
Some preachers, yes. We got some business owners. We have some cooks. We have
everything.
Fashion. We have fun. We have practical things that'll get
for
you through.
Everyday
Listen,
life.
And that is the really goal for this show. And we want to thank all of you guys for tuning in and giving us just a little bit of your time. So, in case you haven't figured it out yet, I'm Tim.
I'm Brelyn.
And we are the Bowmans. And in case you don't know our story, we are celebrating maybe about a year and a half of marriage. And we decided to remain virgins until we got married. We decided to do it according to the book. So we were expecting to get married, have a great, normal, loving marriage. I'm too excited. Let's just sit down. Let me relax. But we were expecting to have just a normal marriage, but God had something different planned for us. Our stories went viral because this fine lady to my left, you girl, she decided to present her father with a certificate of purity, verifying her virginity. Well, everybody didn't like that. When I tell you, social media went insane and they had crazy things. And I'm gonna tell you, my flesh just wanted to pop off on a few people, just a little bit. But we got that under control. We got that under control. But listen, things got crazy.
No, because people kept saying that my father forced me to present the certificate. That's insane.
Crazy.
They even said that I was sleeping with my father. How crazy is that? My father didn't force me to do anything. That was my decision because I wanted to show him that I honor God with my life.
Absolutely.
My life.
But let me tell you how that thing switched. It went from this negative situation, and because we heard from Holy Spirit and God on how to deal with it, he ended up taking that crazy upside down situation and giving us this platform to travel the country, travel the world.
It went mainstream. Yes. I mean, I'm talking Good Morning America, the doctors, the View, everywhere. It was crazy. But listen, now we have the Tim and Brelyn Show. What the devil meant for evil, God literally started.
When you gonna preach, like, girl, preach,
don't
girl.
Don't get me started.
Listen, and this is not just any talk show. When I tell you, we're going to give you principles to live out your day, your life, day to day. As a Christian, people have this big misconception that living the Christian lifestyle and living a holy lifestyle is some unfulfilling lifestyle. But I like to think me and my wife are fly just a little bit. We have fun. We have fun, and we do it God's way. So,
you ready to get the show started?
I'm ready to get this show started.
Listen, y'all give it up for DJ Curly Sue.
The topic of today's show, the topic of today's show is the weight.
The weight.
What better topic to open up the Tim and Brelyn Show than how we got to this point, and that's exhibiting how to weight and save yourself into marriage.
Because a lot of people think it's not possible. They think, you know, they just ain't do that. They lying. He wasn't no virgin when he got married. I mean, how can you be a virgin in this day and time?
Especially dudes. A lot of dudes don't want to say that they were virgins because they think that it messes up their swag. But my saying has been through this whole thing. If
what
you needed sex to boost up your swag, you ain't had much swag in the first place. So listen, I know that greater is he that lives in me than he that lives in the world. So I walk around with the boldness and the confidence to know that God got me, man.
I mean, look at us now. We got the Tim and Brelyn show. Truly, when you honor God, God will literally honor you. I mean, things that you've never expected. I've never expected to be here with you, but God will literally blow your mind. He will do exceedingly abundantly above all that you can ask or think. But I'm so excited because we have Yvonne Orgy.
Come on.
We got some questions from the audience.
Yes, we have Yvonne coming, and we'll get into her in a minute. A lot of people know who she is, but we took some time to poll the audience and see who had questions regarding the topic weight. Now we have Brad here, and his question is, the world tells us, Breeze, that sex is it. How do you speak to teenagers to share what the real it is?
That's your question.
Oh, that's my question. Okay, I'll take that question. You speak to teenagers, and we have a show coming up about relevancy in ministry. You have to know who your target audience is. If I'm talking to a 90-year-old man, I'm going to find 90 year. I'm going to do my research and find 90-year-old ways to connect with him. If we're talking to teenagers about how to save yourself and the importance of doing it God's way, you find ways to connect. You find what they're interested in. And you don't water down the message, but you let them know that God has commanded us and he's given us a mandate to save ourselves.
Absolutely. But you know what? I got somebody else that can answer that question as well. Y'all welcome Yvonne Orgy. Yvonne is joining us on Skype.
Yes. And for those who don't know who Yvonne is, babe, give them a little bit.
Yvonne Orgy. First of all, I've known Yvonne for years, Like, started from the bottom, now we here. But she is Molly on the HBO Insecure.
The hit TV show.
The hit TV show. And I'm so excited because literally she lives this thing out.
She does.
Remaining a virgin. And Yvonne is just a beautiful young lady. She has a powerful testimony. Yes. So, Yvonne, we're just going to jump right into it. We got some questions. How you doing? You doing good?
I'm doing all right. Congratulations, y'all.
Thank you.
Yes. Turn it up. Turn it up. I got my turn up arms for y'all.
Yes. So, listen, the first question is, you were planning to become an OBGYN. Then you got your master's in public health.
Talented and smart.
Right. Only to go into comedy. How did that happen?
Jesus. That's really it. In 2006, I entered a pageant, and I didn't realize I needed a talent because I didn't really know anything about pageants. And they were like, no, you need a talent. I was like, oh, that's cool. I don't have one. And they were like, no, you must have one. So I did the only logical thing to do, which was to pray. And I was like, hey, God, I need you to do me a real solid. I just bought this dress. It was kind of expensive, so And
did you keep the tags on, Yvonne?
I definitely did. It went back.
Yes.
And that was in my post-Jesus days, so you clown on me if you want.
Oh, that was her poor Jesus days. That means she rich now.
That's what the Bible says.
I love it.
I definitely kept the tags on the dress, but I heard back from Holy Spirit, do comedy. Mm-hmm. Now, I'd never done comedy a day in my life. I actually had a fear of rejection because I was bullied as a kid. So it was just the most randomest thing he could have ever told me because I was like, one, I'm not getting up on a stage where people could, like, the first thing they could do is reject me. So you clearly don't know me, Jesus.
Ah.
Holy Spirit got back again and asked me, well, what else do you have? You know when God asks you those rhetorical questions that
like
he already has the answers to? So I decided either I'm going to have faith or nah.
Come on.
And I figured I had read enough stories in the Bible where people walked in faith and it worked out okay for them. So I got up there, I did comedy, and that was 10 years ago.
Well, Yvonne, you know that's good. The Yvonne, the topic of today's show is the weight, and a lot of people don't know your story. You are immensely successful, immensely talented, all that good stuff, but in your private life, you have made the commitment to wait until marriage to have sex. And the audience is itching to ask you some questions. Is that okay?
That's cool. Let's get into it. Y'all know me anyway.
Let's go. We have Rachel here. one of our studio guests, and she wants to know, I know many people who have felt shunned because of their sexual history or that they are now damaged goods, okay? How do you successfully teach abstinence without judgment?
Well, I feel like anything you do shouldn't have judgment in it. And if you walk in the Christian life, I mean, the reason why people are turned off by Christianity is because people are judging them. I'm not any better than anybody else because I haven't had sex. And so for me, I just walk in love. I just say, hey, this is something that I'm not doing. Live your life. But if you like something about my life, this is why and this is how. So if you want my happy, if you want my joy, if you want my peace, I can only tell you how I got it. No pressure, but if that's not for you, then that's cool. Right. If it's working out, then rock on.
Come on.
So this next question is, how can I become celibate when I've been doing this since I was 13 years old?
I think everything, you know, your dad, Brelyn, who was my pastor, Pastor Mike, he would always say, life is choice driven. You live and die by the choices and decisions that you make. And I think that everything we do in life is making one choice one day at a time. To exercise, you decide I'm gonna get up at 6 a.m. and exercise. And you just keep doing that day in, day out. And before you know, you don't lose 20 pounds. You're like, oh, but look at Jesus.
The consistency.
Exactly.
You have to be. Yeah. And shout out to who she's referring to.
Yes.
From Maryland and all over the country, all over the world, Dr. Mike Freeman, who is my bishop. Shout out to you.
But look, I do have a question. I do have a question because the show that you're on, of course, we know about the show Insecure. And how do you separate the two? How do you have this show, but then now you're saying I'm a virgin? How do you now deal with those thoughts and cast down those thoughts when you get home, you know, because you've practiced all this, you know, script and everything else. But when you get home, how do you deal with that?
Good question.
Well, you know, before I even took the job, you know, I pray about everything. For me, I didn't ask to be in Hollywood. It's a dream that literally got put on me and in me. So for me to sustain this business, it has to go with a green light from him. So I prayed. I'm like, all right, God, what we doing? And before I even got the role, I just knew what kind of actress I wanted to be and what were non-negotiables in the business. And you know, my character Molly, she does get it in, but I have to find a way to marry maintaining my brand and keeping the vision that somebody else has. Because at the end of the day, it's a job. It's like on your job, your boss may ask you to do some stuff that you're like, I don't really, okay, well, listen. So for me, we had conversations. I'm all about transparency and using your words. For me, everybody knows my testimony. Everybody knows my background. Everybody knows it was very uncomfortable. So they had safeguards. Mm-hmm. I talked with directors and they were like, you know what? Nudity's not an option. Great. We'll put you in clothes that cover, you know, while we do this scene. We'll shoot it this way so we don't see too much skin. So there's ways to cheat things in Hollywood. And also, I think people knew that I was consistent. It wasn't like I'm posting stuff on Instagram and living a different life than what I'm telling them I'm doing, because then that'll be
that's good, sketchy.
You know? Like, how can you honor my word and saying like, hey, I really want to protect this part of me, but then you see me living a different lifestyle. And you're like, well, girl, kill yourself. You're going to go ahead and put this booty shorts on.
When I tell you, I could literally sit here and talk to you about this for hours.
You know, this is our heart.
This is our heart. And this country loves you. We thank you for what you're standing for and the biblical principles. Yes. Really quickly, give us how we can stay up with you on social media.
At Yvonne Orji, that's O-R-J-I.
Yes.
Well, we thank you one more time for coming
thank
and kicking
so
with me
much.
And Breeze. Listen. Well, we have a musical guest that I've stole some of his riffs. I've stole some of his runs myself. But this guy has traveled the country. He has traveled the world sharing about Jesus Christ. Give it up for the one and only Mr. D'Angelo Gardner.
Come on, I got some worshipers in the room. Is there anybody saying, Father, in light of everything that's going on around us, we just want you to take your place. Is that all right?
Yes.
Say, hands up, hearts open, wide as a sky. We lift you high. We lift you high. Hands up, hearts open, wide as we cry. God, we lift you high. get your name high. Hands up, hearts open, wide as the sky. We lift you high. Father, we lift you high. Let all the other names fade away. Yeah. Let all the other names fade away. Until there's only you. All the other names fade away. So Jesus, take your place. Yeah. Jesus, take your place. Come on.
Just tell us a little bit about you, real briefly.
Well, I'm D'Angelo Gardner, and from Detroit, Michigan. This is my city. And I'm just extremely glad to just do what God has given me to do in front of the world. You know, I'm just grateful to do this.
Come on, now, do you have any new music, anything that we can catch up?
Actually, there is music going on in the works, but God has given us a major assignment. My wife and I, we're getting ready to launch a ministry in April. Called Faith City Church.
Come on, come on, come on.
And I'm extremely glad about it.
People don't understand the importance of discipleship. We get so important. We get so caught up in just going out and singing and doing all these things. But the New Testament really calls us to go out and win souls and win things like that. So I want to thank you for answering that call and doing that. Where can we stay up with you on social media?
Facebook is D'Angelo Gardner. Instagram is D'Angelo Gardner. And then the website is awakeningfaith.city.
Come on, one more time. Let's give it up for Mr. D'Angelo Gardner. Do not go anywhere, because coming up, my wife is getting ready to let you in her closet with the amazing Miss Tam Lee. They talking fashion. They talking all that good stuff. I may go in there and try to snoop around and see what's going on. But stay right there. We're coming back with Brelyn's Closet.
I wouldn't want to do life without you. I'm good.
The Tim and Brelyn Show is what everybody's talking about.
Let me set some guidelines.
Oh,
This is your show. This is my show.
It's real talk, real issues.
I always say it because you have to remember where you come from, and it's about Jesus, and he'll elevate you when it's your time.
You just never know who's going to stop by.
What are you doing here?
I'm good enough. Every Saturday at 1:30 p.m., only on the Word Network.
Next segment, because I love fashion. I'm so into fashion. I'm so into how I look, because you can still be fly and be saved at the same time, right? Yes. So I'm excited because we have my sister friend in the building. Yes. Tam Hush Lee. Tam, I mean, you're an amazing stylist. She styled me for the show. She just keep me looking good.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So on this segment, she's going to share with us what's hot and what's not. So Tam, tell us what's hot and what's not. How do we keep it fly? You know, how do we keep it conservative? I mean, because we can't be sexy without, you know, chest all out. How do you do that?
It's not that hard. It's not that hard. It's not that hard because you know
deep
what,
breaths.
You guys, right. Take a deep breath. It's not that hard. We are agents here for God on the earth. So we gotta watch out what we wear.
Okay, right, we didn't call you to preach. We called you to show some cook.
But I'm just saying, you know, I got good pastors. You know, that's what they do.
This is Brelyn's closet, but
you
I
let me in the closet.
In the closet, so we gotta deal with him, y'all.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. But it's not hard, you guys. So I know, you know, every season we get used to some of the trends that were there, and sometimes we gotta let some things go. We got to toss some things and we got to keep some things. And so I'm going to talk about what's hot and what's not this season. The first thing, you guys, we're going to give our feet some comfort. We're
like
not
that.
Going. Yes. Okay. And all the ladies say amen.
Amen.
Because we are not going to do these high 6-inch heels anymore. Yes.
So those are out?
Well, you know what? They still have them, but they're not as popular.
Okay.
No, those aren't that high. Okay. These are really, really high.
Yeah.
So
okay.
These are, you know, high. So then we're going to go a little bit lower.
Mm-hmm.
We're
going to
like 4 inches.
Okay.
Yeah.
That feels
right.
Better.
Right. So your feet are not on the fire for Jesus in church,
these?
Okay?
I don't even understand. This is a weapon.
Yeah, no, it really is. And so this season is really about comfort. It's really about versatility, just, you know, trying to relax. And so that's going to be in block heels. They're
ooh,
coming
cute.
Back. Yeah. You love this? This Gucci is really cute. It's a classic. But the block heels are going to be back in. And so one other thing that's really hot right now, you guys, is embellishments. Everything is embellished from your jeans, you know, your jackets, and you don't have to spend a lot of money on it. You can always go and pick up some of these little brooches, and you can put these right on any of your jackets, your
super
jeans.
Super cute.
Yeah, patches. You can get those iron-on patches, or you can just buy them.
So you iron them on yourself?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, that's sweet. That's sweet.
You iron them yourself. And I mean, they have them from low-end designers to high-end designers, so you can make your own or you can buy them, you know?
That's cute. So what do you have on this rack here?
Yeah. All right, so come on. So I know you guys, I know some ladies don't like pink, but pink is here to stay.
It's
so
cute.
Yes, so you've got to get used to the pink. You got to get used to the pink because that's what you're going to see in all the storefronts. You're going to see that this dusty pink and this hot pink.
That's
all
cute.
Shades of pink.
So now is some of this stuff on your website?
Yeah, absolutely. LoveHushBoutique.com. You guys got to go on there and shop.
Perfect.
And
if you shop today, use the promo code Tim and Brelyn.
Yeah.
And Tim's going to take care of you. She's going to, you know, make sure you get
that
good stuff.
No,
okay. Don't tell them. Yeah, it's a surprise code.
You
got to go and check it out.
You
Tam,
go
I love you. I'm so grateful that you came to share what's hot and what's not with us. But stay tuned. We'll be right back after this break.
The Tim and Brelyn Show is what everybody's talking about.
Let me set some guidelines.
Oh,
set
this, some guidelines. Oh, this is your
this
show.
This is my show.
Ah!
It's real talk, real issues.
I always say it because you have to remember where you come from, and it's about Jesus, and he'll elevate you when it's your time.
You just never know who's going to stop by.
What are you doing here?
I'm good enough.
Every Saturday at 1:30 p.m., only on the Word Network.
Listen, my wife, I can tell you right now what my wife is thinking. I told you not to eat that apple right before we came from this break. But I'm gonna finish.
This is
my,
what happens when you come to our kitchen, when you come hang out with us. You see, we got the setup. Y'all like our new set? It's amazing.
But we've come to the time that we always tell you that is our saddest moment of the show, because we have to say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Yeah, this is this is horrible. I want to thank our guests for today.
Yes, Yvonne Orgy.
Yvonne, thank you so much.
D'Angelo.
Yes, D'Angelo, man. It should be a crime to sing the way this guy sings. And Tam Hushley.
Tam Hushley. Yes. Listen, today was our first episode, and we talked about the weight. But if you want to know more about the weight, if you want to share your story, we want you to hashtag the Tim and Brelyn Show. So hashtag that. Let us know how you enjoyed the show. Share and tell somebody about it, and you'll catch us next week.
Thank you to Mr. Kevin Adele and the Word Network for this wonderful opportunity.
Yes. So we our do wonderful not studio audience.
Our studio audience, our staff, our producers. All that good stuff. Yes. We thank you. Thank you so much to you for tuning in. Y'all don't understand how much we don't take this for granted.
Right.
We're expecting these next few months and years to be a spiritual roller coaster. And that's going to be an amazing roller coaster.
Amazing.
And we thank you for traveling on that with us. I'll tell you, there's going to be some highs. Like I told you, we have some great singers, some great teachers, some great preachers. Like today, we have some great kingdom businesses. Yeah. And this is the forum for that. We want it to be multifaceted in how we represent and how we present kingdom living. Yeah. It's not all about...
Because we need to know how to live everyday life.
Come on, come on.
Just everyday life. Give me some tips.
So many Christians are going to church, and then Monday, they're dying again. And then Monday through Saturday, but I'm about a whole life, and I'm about living Jesus and living kingdom-minded Monday through Sunday.
Really
Sunday through Monday.
Really being doers of the word and not just hearers of the word. And that's what the Tim and Brelyn Show is about. It's for everybody, for your mama, your auntie, your uncle, your babies, everybody. This show is for everybody. This is so exciting because we've learned that when you honor God, God will truly honor you.
Literally. We're living witnesses. If you want to call or go online and donate to the show, we would love that. You can do that at meetthebowmans.com. This fine woman there, I got to stop looking to my left because she keeps taking my breath away. But you can do that at meetthebowmans.com.
Absolutely.
Again, thank you so much for hanging with us. Tune in every week. I promise you won't regret
it. We'll see you next week.